Besides, find a way out when the sun comes up.
Fine couple of game hunters we are. Come all the way over here from New York, and the first night out, we get lost.
You know, maybe we took the high road instead of the low road. Hey, you want a drink?
No, thanks.
Good. This leaves more for me.
Now I thought you told me you were gonna cut down on that stuff.
Yeah, I did. But I'm a terrible liar. Besides, it doesn't pay. You know, I remember this one time when I was going with this really wonderful girl. And she used to plead with me. And I mean plead with me to give it up. So, one day I did. Then we discovered that we didn't have anything else to talk about. So we broke up.
There's something about this forest that gives me the feeling of being a thief.
Well, if we were, I'd know where the exit was.
You don't believe me.
Sure I do.
Really? Like what?
Practically anything I can understand. You know, anything that's real to me. Like things I can taste.
Touch. Swallow.
What about the things you don't understand?
I dismiss them.
Well, that makes everything very easy, doesn't it?
I'd say comfortable is the word.
Inferiority.
You don't deserve it.
What do you mean?
Well, most of my friends who have
town square where he can see them being reminded.
Aye.
This is the second day of our blessing. It is to remind you of the obligations we have so gratefully accepted.
Aye.
And so I shall hang near the town square, as I told Mr. Lillian would.
Would you have a waistcoat of this that would fit it?
I think so.
Tommy Albright. Oh, this is my friend Jeff Douglas.
Happy to say.
Hi.
I met Bucky!
Well, I'm glad you're happy about it.
There's a little tavern on the next street where you can get some food. Come on, I'll take you to it.
Go ahead, Jeff. I'll call the inn first.
Excuse me, sir. But Miss May going to be taking care of him?
Yes, I think so. Why?
Well, I have some little travelers here. When you leave the tavern, Miss May should take you somewhere to rest. And you have any room for your own on a thistle? I do want to be for you.
Well, thank you very much, but I don't plan on getting stuck.
You don't know how, Eddie, but you're stuck already.
Attend to your son, Mrs. Beaton.
What a place. Is there a phone around here?
A phone?
Yes.
I didn't think you had one.
No phone?
No, sir.
Tell me, what's so strange about this place?
Nothing, sir. You're the one who's strange.
Charlie, give the bottle of the letter. Have a grab of the letter.
Well, Mary Bridegroom himself.
Good morning, darling.
Bridegroom?
Aye. He's marrying my sister this evening.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Charlie, I'd like you to meet Tommy Albright. He just happened in a little while ago.
What?
Oh, why, of course. Well, welcome here, sir.
Thanks. Well, welcome to you.
Here's your friend, Charlie.
I'm Yangus.
And how about you, sir?
Thanks.
I think I'll drink this one.
Think it's a ball sack?
I just don't think all is out the way for my men. I'll postpone the meal.
The what?
And may God bless me this evening, as much as I would bless him, if I were he and he were Charles Dalrymple.
What did you say about postponing the miracle?
Oh, he's a toss we have here.
Take it down. I'll explain it to you sometime.
about it, but you feel guilty. And your conscience will make you do it.
I must say, it didn't sound like you love her very much.
No, it does not.
And it also sounds like a very peculiar lad to come from.
Oh, well, believe me, lass, this isn't the usual Hamlet off the highway either. What is that business about Charlie and the man who postponed the miracle?
Oh, that. I'm sorry. I can't say.
Now, you said you'd tell me later.
I know, but I can't say.
That's fine. You know, if I stick around this place long enough, I'll probably discover that everybody in it is off their rocker. Is that possible?
I can't say.
Why not?
Because I didn't know what off the rocker means.
It means taking a sink.
Well, then, I can assure you, we're all fine and sane. We're a most pleasant group of people. And I never realized how fortunate we are until I meet someone from the outside. I mean, a stranger to Brigadoon. I didn't know anything about you, but from the little you said, I'm quite certain that everything you think, I think differently about. And I'm also quite certain that what I think is much more, well, pleasant. I know I'm sorry I said all that, but you angered me when you called us insane.
Hey, you don't like me very much, do you?
That's the odd part. I like you very much. I just didn't like anything you said.
Fiona.
Aye.
If I stuck around here today, would you take me to that wedding this evening?
Why is something want to go?
Oh, I
can't say.
Well, then I'll take you, and I'll be highly pleased to be there.
You will?
Why?
Because of what you just told him. I like you very much.
That's right. You did say that, didn't you?
Now I'll show you some places where you can lie down and rest.
What are you going to do?
Gather some heather for the wedding.
Where do you do that?
On the hill, where the heather is.
Can I go with you?
Oh no, I'll do it much faster at all.
Oh, I won't bother you. Really? Maybe I'm the one who's off his rocker. But
can't we two go walk into heaven out beyond the valley of trees? Out where there's a hillside of heaven, curtsying gently in the breeze. That's what I'd like to do. See the
and all without a holding still.
you take my hand? I'm not sure of me.
You may not mean to be, but you are. And so is everyone else in this town.
Why did you go about keeping everybody back?
I couldn't get through this day without seeing her married to someone else. If I did not, what can I do? What can anyone do? The hate when you realize your life isn't even a dime. I cannot be here. I cannot go to university and make something of myself. I cannot have a gene. So there's nothing left for me to do. Take everybody, everything in this cursed town.
You'll never find any peace by being mad. It only shuts you off from the world. And this is only a cursed town. If you make it so, to the rest of us, it is a blessed place.
And he can keep it.
Well, I'm all done.
What is that?
My waistcoat came.
Oh, Jamie!
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Wait for me. I shot in just a few minutes.
Yeah.
Get this.
Charles McPherson Garden, April 21st, 1799. Nobody said that.
Congratulations.
Hey, no reason on the map. No phones in the whole town. I think Smith said somebody about being something about a miracle. And one or two other things I passed over when I was out with Fiona this afternoon.
Yeah. You know what? That hydrogen fire when I was with, she's never even heard of Monica Lewinsky.
I don't understand this. And I began to feel like a fool.
You know, I don't know what you're getting so worked up about. If it makes them happy to disregard 200 years of human history, let them.
But I just spent the most wonderful day of my life. And now I run into something like this. It just doesn't make sense to me.
Does to me. Just means that crazy people relax you.
She's not crazy. She can't be. Fiona! There must be a logical explanation to this. Even logical enough for you. Fiona!
They don't have to explain anything to me. I don't care.
What, Tony?
Is that your name in that button over there?
Hi. Inviting. Oh.
Someone seems to have boxed up your books.
Well, come on. What does it mean? Is there an explanation or isn't there?
Aye, there is. But I can't tell you.
Well, is there anyone around you who can? I'd like to know.
You'll have to speak with the Dominie.
The who?
Our schoolmaster, Mr. Lundy.
Where does he live?
Down the road, in a tree!
He doesn't live in a tree, Mr. Douglas. Mr. Lundy is a great man. All right, I'll take it to you. I hadn't wanted to, because I was hoping we could have him stay here.
Is that got to do
with it? It's going to be so hard for you to believe what you'll hear. You'll think there's something wrong with us, and you'll leave. I know it.
Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. Come on, Jeff.
Wait, is this informal or should I wear my three-quarter hat?
Come on, I said.
Wednesday.
That means it happened exactly 200 years. years ago, 200 years ago, the Highlands of Scotland were plagued with witches. Wicked sorcerers who had taken the Scottish folk away from the teachings of God and put in the devil in their souls. They were indeed horrible and destructive women. I didn't you suppose you have such women in Rome?
Witches?
Oh yeah, we still got them. Just pronounce it a little different.
It didn't matter because they were not real sorcerers, because he and I both know that there's no such thing. But their influence was very real indeed. Now here in Brigadoon we had an old minister of the Kirk and Mr. Forsyth, and a good man he was.
The kindest man in Scotland.
I believe he was. No man ever loved his parish as did Mr. Forsyth. But he was growing old. It grieved him to think that one day soon he would have to leave all those so dear to him. But most of all, he worried about the witches. And he wondered if there wasn't something he could do to protect the poor's parish. Not only from the witches, but from all the evils that might come to Brigadoon from the outside world. He spent many days walking through the land thinking, and if he had passed his house at any hour of the night, you would have seen him sitting in his chair thinking. And then one day he came to me and told me that he had decided to ask God for a miracle.
This part is so nice. I could cry thinking about it.
He consulted with me about it because he knew I had a kind of lawful mind. And he figured as long as he was going to ask for a miracle, well, it might as well be a well organized game. So, for many days I walked with him through the glen. Many nights I sat with him by candlelight. And finally, Mr. Forsyth decided what he was going to pray for. On an early Wednesday morning, right after midnight, Mr. Forsyth went out to a hill beyond Brigadoon and made his prayer to God. There, in the hush of a sleeping world, Mr. Forsyth asked God to make Brigadoon all the people in it vanish, but not for always. They would return just as they were, every day, every 100 years. They would go on leading their customary lives, but every morning when they awoke, it would be 100 years later. And when we awoke the next morning, it was 100 years later.
My God.
You see, in this way, Mr. Forsyth figured there would be no change in the lives of the people. They just wouldn't be in the city long enough to be touched by it.
You mean, you go to bed at night, and when you get up the next morning, it's 100 years later?
Aye.
Then every day is 100 years later?
Aye.
What happened to the minister?
We never saw him again. You see, he realized that to ask for such a miracle, that some sacrifices have to be made. Well, he wanted to be the one to make it. Now, what would be the greatest sacrifice he could make? It was to be separated before his time from the ones he loved. That's why he went out to the hill, beyond Brigadoon. If the miracle were granted, he would never see Brigadoon again.
And all this happened 200 years ago.
Aye, but you see, he's only 2 days to us. And Mr. Forsyth had intended to ask for the miracle on a Tuesday. But Charles Darwin was away at school in Edinburgh, and he wasn't expected back till Tuesday late. And Mr. Forsyth did not want anything to go wrong with the weather. Postponed praying until Charlie got back.
Let me ask you something. Suppose somebody around here gets tired of it and wants to leave. What then?
He can't leave.
Wait, you mean I've got to stay here now?
No, no, no.
Thank you.
There's no need for greedy now. You must see it all the way to something.
Then you didn't get away, Mr. McLeod.
No, I didn't.
Then what is he? I want to see my son. I thank God this happened with terrible intention. But I want to see my son.
He's all right, Eddie. He's in good hands. Besides, it is best he left alone for a while. Come, join us for a bit of supper.
I'm too ashamed, Mr. McLeod. I cannot join you.
But then, come everyone, back to the room. You all go.
Angus, have you seen Tommy?
The American Fiona? I did not think he came back with us.
Come, Fiona.
Just for the record.
What are you talking about?
I'm staying here.
You're pulling my body away, aren't you?
No. No. I've never been more serious in my life. I'll tell you, Jeff. In one day, I feel more a part of her and all this than I ever felt about Jade or anything or anybody back home.
Tommy, that's because it is just one day. But don't you realize that if you stay here, it's for always?
I know.
Well, and do you know how long always is around here? Well, it's one hell of a long time.
I know.
This can't be a trial marriage. You can't change your mind for trying it out for 600 or 700 years.
I won't ever want to.
Oh, and you're absolutely positive that there will never come a time when you'll miss your family, your friends, the life you belong to. How can you know that now?
Because, well, now here's why I know you think I'm crazy. Because I believe in her. And what's more, I believe in this place.
Do not. You just think you do. This Highlander Brigadoon town, it makes no more sense to you than it does to me. So how can you believe in something when you don't even understand it? When we leave here in a few weeks, or even a few days, you'll forget all about it. You won't even feel a thing. Because that's the way a dream is.
What do you mean, a dream?
Well, that's what this is. A dream. Why, even now, you're not really moved by it. You just think you are.
How do you know?
Because I do. Did you see that funeral here a moment ago?
Yeah. Why?
I'm responsible for it.
What are you talking about?
Harry Beaton? I killed him.
You did what?
I killed him! Well, accidentally, of course, but nevertheless, I killed him. Out of the forest tonight, I saw a muscle pass his mouth behind a bushel. And without even thinking, I stuck out my foot. Down he went, and I heard his hand hit a rock with a very nasty thud.
Oh my God, Jeff, I'm so sorry.
What for?
You must feel half dead inside.
On the contrary, I don't feel a thing.
Why don't you?
Because this is a dream. It's a good one for you, and it's a bad one for me.
Wait a minute. Just one minute, will you?
See? I confused the heaven.
Yeah. Amen.
And if you really believe as much as you think you do, I couldn't have done that. I'll wait for you outside of town.
Thank you.
must be sorry about you.
I get back to the conversation. They ask me a question. I don't know what the heck.
see for myself, this really wasn't good.
Didn't work that way for me. You know, it seems so much like a dream to me now that I'd have to work hard to convince myself it even happened at all.
There's a big difference between us.
Tell me about it.
I found that sometimes what you believe in becomes more real to you than all the things you can explain away or understand. Jeez. Why do people have to lose things to find out what they mean?